Cray 4 has finally nailed the sport of rallying good and proper. So is there still an inviting gap up the inside for WRC3 to squeeze through? As with WRC2 Extreme, the expertise of this latest outing lies in providing a player with just about everything the World Championship has to offer. All the official WRC licensing elements have been updated for the 2003 season, including new teams, drivers, car specs and countries, including the all-new Turkish Rally stages. But there's still no other cars to race against. It's just you and a few hundred miles of the world's worst terrain for company. The previous WRC was renowned for having the longest viewing distances of any driving game, and every time the road straightened out, you could literally see for miles up ahead. Now the developer has extended it even further, and if you see a pretty mountain in the background, it's not just there for show. Chances are you'll be crawling up it in a few minutes' time. Evolution Studios have also broken boundaries in the special effects department too. Thanks to some clever new technical trickery, shrapnel particle emitters allow for bodywork and glass to come flying off should you make an overzealous stab with the analog stick. And the whole thing looks as authentic and detailed as you could possibly want. The question still remains as to whether the handling corrections have solved all the twitchy and oversensitive steering issues. If so, then WRC3 will undoubtedly push your driving ability to the limits. And while it first appears to do pretty much the same as McRae 4 on a basic level, it could well provide a much nicer paint job and a greater sense of authenticity with proper WRC cars, drivers, and official events.